yeah, guys? Let's see what you guys could do. Come on. Okay, that's that guy. Now we just have Captain Oliver here with his little gun. Yeah, right, buddy. That was not happening. Let's see, let's take that. Let's see, we'll take both. What? Okay, he had a light machine gun and he's using his fucking revolver. Yeah, I'm not too scared of you, buddy. I like how blood spurts out, even though, you know, he is wearing pretty thick armor. Yeah, fuck it. Are you serious? Where are these guys coming from? Are there, is there still gonna be more? No? Okay, thank God. God. Kill one and two more would take their place. Cola, and how about some of that, and just for shits and giggles, let's take a super stim pack, since I have a shit ton of them. Yeah, that was definitely way overkilled. Oh, nothing in their foot lockers? That's bullshit. Now, let's see, am I supposed to go all the way back downstairs? I don't know. What does the quest say? I didn't see if something new popped up. And the soldiers guarding him. Could be mistaken, but he looks pretty dead. I don't think he's gonna die anymore. Is there somebody else to find? Is there like any other guards? Maybe hiding somewhere? Oh, there we are. Uh-huh. I knew there had to be more guards. There, that couldn't be all of them. Is that gonna update the quest then? Yeah, okay. Turn the leg and tell him he has been killed. Yeah, I figured they must have done that too, so that you couldn't just like running, kill the easiest guy to kill in the world with his no armor and didn't feel like using his real gun. I'm scared that I'm gonna hit a giant explosion again. I don't know what that was. Arm that though. Huh, whatever. Guess I'm good now. Nope, they still have their magical force fields going. I guess they did have those in Fallout 3 too. And then Fallout 3 also fucking that didn't take long to find them.
This slaughter pleases me. No act is more sacred than consecrating a site in the blood of one's enemies. The rest of the dam is fully under our control.
Wow, that didn't take long.
A few pitiful holdouts remain, but their time is short. The general was the last source of concern. With their commander dead, the NCR will pull out of this region, allowing our conquest to continue westward, unopposed for a time. The Legion will swell with the number of slaves we will claim from this place, and the tribute we gather will fund further campaigns. Perhaps in time, I will be granted the honor of conquering the land known as California. But for now, we rest. Know
okay,
that your
then.
Efforts are appreciated and will not go unrewarded. But we can speak of that later. For now, come. We must see to the burning of the dead.
Wow, that felt...
And so the courier
okay, I'll just let this go.
In the cemetery outside Good Springs, cheated death once again. And the Mojave Wasteland was forever changed.
I bet.
Caesar entered the strip as though it was his triumph. The Legion pushed the NCR out of New Vegas entirely, driving them back to the Mojave outpost. The Legion occupied all
which
major
doesn't have anything
locations,
in it.
Enslaving much of the population and peacefully lording over the rest. Under the Legion's banner, civilization, unforgiving as it was, finally came to the Mojave Wasteland. The Courier, a mercenary at heart, helped the Legion achieve victory at Hoover Dam. Caesar honored him with a golden coin, minted in celebration of his contributions, and distributed throughout the wasteland.
Though some super mutants and Nightkin continued to journey to the legendary Utopitha, they found little trace of its existence. Some eventually found their way to Jacobstown, but many wandered off into the wastes, confused and disheartened.
Cautious after the Boomers' display of power at Hoover Dam, Caesar chose to leave the Boomers alone.
Smart.
The Boomers remained isolated, but have been seen flying over the Mojave Desert from time to time.
Buried beneath tons of rubble, the Mojave chapter of the Brotherhood of Steel was no more.
Whoops.
Those few who were outside the Hidden Valley bunker when it was destroyed settled into new lives, or headed west to find a new chapter to join.
The Fiends attacked Camp McCarran during the second battle of Hoover Dam and suffered heavy losses. Caesar, unimpressed with their performance and their dependence on Chems, had them exterminated.
After the Legion's victory, Caesar, out of a strange respect for his old fellows, allowed the followers safe passage out of the wasteland. Reluctantly, the followers accepted the offer and abandoned Old Mormon Fort to the Legion.
Travelers continued to stop by Good Springs Source for water on the Long 15, but rarely would anyone venture into the ruins of Good Springs itself. Those who did were almost always tourists, come to visit the graveyard where the courier rose from the dead.
As reward for their loyal service, Caesar forcibly integrated the Great Khans into the Legion. The sick and elderly were killed, the women sold as wives to ranking officers, and the tribe's identity was annihilated. Though many Great Khans mourned the death of their tribe, many more were ultimately satisfied with their revenge against NCR.
Impressed with the King's continued attacks upon NCR citizens and soldiers, the Legion offered them the option of being assimilated into the Legion. The Kings refused and briefly became slaves in the Legion, but after a failed escape attempt, they were all put to death.
Aww.
During the Legion's attack on Novak, Bright followers returning from their long pilgrimage assisted in its evacuation. Though Novak eventually fell to the Legion, many citizens of Novak were able to escape, alive and intact.
Most powder gangers at the correctional facility fled into the wasteland rather than face the advancing forces of the Legion. Those brave or foolish to remain were killed or crucified by the merciless legionaries.
Armed with a wide array of improvised explosives and stolen weapons, the Vault 19 Powder Gang tormented the Mojave Wasteland for years. Citizens of the NCR were favorite targets, and they always suffered the worst fates.
Hot-headed to the end, Sheriff Myers chooses to oppose Caesar's takeover of Prim with a standoff. Though the citizens take out a few legionaries, the town quickly falls to Caesar, its citizens utterly wiped out.
What a surprise.
And so the courier's road came to an end.
Well, there we go.
In the new world of the Mojave Wasteland, fighting continued, blood was spilled, and many lived and died just as they had in the old world. Because war never changes.